Hi there, this is Peter Bos with a small demonstration on how to simplify a mesh within MeshLab. The first thing you need to have is a mesh to simplify. You could download something from Thingiverse. In this case I will download the Stanford Bunny, which is quite a complicated mesh. So it's a nice example to simplify. Once you downloaded it, you open it up in MeshLab. Those people who do not know what MeshLab is, MeshLab is a great tool to do all sorts of stuff with meshes, 3D objects. But it can be quite daunting to operate because it's full of difficult filters and such. You open up the mesh, in this case an STL file. And it will show up. If you don't have something like that, try turn on the lighting, or something that also helps is double-sided lighting. If you turn that on, you will essentially light the object inside and outside. But that's not what we're doing here. We want to simplify this object. When you want to print this object on a 3D printer, it can take quite a long while, and that's because of the complexity of the object. How to simplify it? Well, it's quite simple. Below filters, there's an option remeshing, simplification, and reconstruction. And you have to look for the filter that's called quadric edge collapsion. Collapse decimation. Damn, that's hard to pronounce. You click on it and you get a little pop-up. And the easiest thing to do, I find, is just to hit in a percentage for the simplification. I will do quite a large simplification. I will reduce the vertices by half. The only thing you have to do is click apply. It will start calculating. And it's a bit hard to see, but it's more simple now. I will repeat this simplification a couple of times. And you see objects get simpler and simpler. And now you have a real abstract bunny. And you could do this with any object. It's all particularly useful when you are scanning objects with a 3D scanner, because you have a lot of vertices in those kind of objects. And you really don't need all those points. Well, I hope this wasn't too long of a demo. I hope you enjoyed it.